Hi everyone, Monisha here. In this video, I will be completing question number 1 to question number 7 of exercise 4.2. So this exercise is very important. Usually in board exam, you will get two questions, one for 2 marks and the for 3 marks. So watch till the end so that you can understand the concept clearly. Let us start the session. Exercise 4.2, first question is, from a point Q, the length of the tangent to a circle is 24 cm. So from a point Q in the diagram, you can see that from point Q, the tangent is PQ. Here PQ is the tangent. So the length of the tangent given here is 24. And the distance of Q from the center. So from the center, that is from O, the distance to the Q is 25 cm. Okay. Here we need to find out the radius. The radius is OP. Okay. So we need to find out the radius OP. So OP we need to find out. Tangent PQ is given. PQ is equal to 24 cm and OQ is 25 cm. Okay. So here by perpendicular theorem, so this OP will become perpendicular to PQ. So we can apply Pythagoras theorem here. By Pythagoras theorem. So here, if this is 90 degree, this side, OQ side will be hypotenuse. So hypotenuse square, OQ square is equal to OP square plus PQ square. So here OQ is 25. So 25 square is equal to OP, right as it is, OP square plus PQ is 24 square. So 25 square is 25 into 25, 625 is equal to OP square plus 24 into 24 is 576. So next I will shift, this is 24 square is 576. If you want, you can multiply and see it. Okay. So next I am shifting this 576 to left hand side. So it is 625 minus 576 is equal to OP square. So 625 minus 576 is 49 is equal to OP square. So when I shift this square to this side, it will become square root. Therefore OP is equal to square root of 49. The square root of 49 is 7. So the value for radius OP is 7 cm. So the value for this OP is 7 cm. Hope you understood this problem well. The second question is, in the given figure, if TP and TQ are the two tangents to a circle with center O, so that angle POQ is equal to 110 degree, then PTQ is equal to dash. We need to find out what is the value for angle PTQ. Okay. So here, in the question itself, they have given TP and TQ are the tangents. Okay. So given TP and TQ are the tangents. So by perpendicular theorem, if tangents are touching the circle with the radius, then this perpendicular line, so this radius will become perpendicular to the tangent. By perpendicular theorem, what happens? If the radius and the tangent are touching at a point of contact, then it will be 90 degree. So here OP will be perpendicular to TP and OQ will be perpendicular to TQ. So by theorem 4.1 or perpendicular theorem, so here OP will be perpendicular to TP and OQ will be perpendicular to TQ. So when it becomes perpendicular, these both are 90 degree. Therefore, angle OPT and angle OQT. So both will be equal to 90 degree. So next we can notice in the diagram. So this OPTQ is a quadrilateral. Okay. So the interior angles of the quadrilateral is equal to 360 degree. Okay. So in a quadrilateral, OPTQ, the sum of the interior angles is equal to 360 degree. Okay. So here the interior angles are, first one is POQ or PQO. So angle POQ plus angle OPT plus angle OQT and angle PTQ. So POQ, OPT, OQT and PTQ. Okay. So all these angles, the sum of all the interior angles is equal to 360 degrees. Here POQ is given in the question, that is 110 degree, plus OPT and OQT is 90 degree. So PTQ we need to find out. Okay, so here 110 degree plus 90 degree plus 90 degree is 180 degree plus PTQ is equal to 360. So here 110 plus 180 is 290 degree plus PTQ is equal to 360. In the next step, I will be shifting this 290 to right hand side. It will become PTQ is equal to 360 minus 290. So that is 70 degree. So therefore, the angle PTQ is equal to 70 degree. So the option is B. The B option is the correct answer. Okay, hope you understood this. Coming to the third question. The third question is, if tangents PA and PB from a point P to a circle with the center O are inclined to each other at an angle 80 degree, then angle POA is equal to dash. So here the angle APB is given. Okay, so here the angle APB is 80 degree. So we need to find out the angle POA. Okay, so this angle POA angle we need to find out. Okay, so here since they have given in the question itself, PA and PB are the two tangents. Okay, so given PA and PB are the tangents. So when PA and PB are the tangents, by theorem 4.1, that is perpendicular theorem, what happens? From theorem 4.1, so this radius will be perpendicular to tangent. Okay, theorem 4.1, perpendicular theorem states that, so whenever a tangent touches a point on the circle with the radius, then that radius will be perpendicular to the tangent. So from theorem 4.1, here OA will become perpendicular to PA and OB will be perpendicular to PB. Okay, so when OA and OB becomes perpendicular, this angle will become 90 degree. Okay, so therefore OAP will be 90 degree and OBP will also be 90 degree. Fine. Next, we need to find the angles of all the sides of the quadrilateral. Okay, all the angles in the quadrilateral. Okay, so in a quadrilateral, OBPA, the sum of interior angles is equal to 360 degree. So the all the angles of a quadrilateral, the sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 360 degree. The sum of interior angles. The sum of interior angles is equal to 360. We need to write all the angles here. That is, first one is OAP plus OBP plus APB plus AOB. Okay, so these are all four interior angles in a quadrilateral, which will be equal to 360 degree. Where by theorem 4.1 we know that AOP and OBP and OAP are 90 degree, and the APB value is already given in the question itself, that is 80 degree. We need to find AOB now. Okay, so 90 plus 90 is 180, 180 plus 80 is 260. So 260 degree plus AOB is equal to 360. So AOB angle is equal to 360 minus 260. So that will be 100 degree. So this is not the answer, because they have asked to find out POA. So now what we have to do is, here there are two triangles. One is OAP triangle and the one is OBP triangle. We need to compare both. Okay. In triangle OAP and triangle OBP. Okay. So what are same here? One is radius. OA is equal to OB, because radii drawn to the same circle. Okay. Radii. Next, in both the triangle, OP is the common side. So OP is equal to OP, common side. Next, tangent. They are already given two tangents are there, and two tangents are equal to each other. Okay. So PA is equal to PB, tangents drawn to the circle. So when three sides of a triangle, when three sides of two triangles are equal, then by SSS similarity criterion, that is SSS, side similarity criterion, so by SSS similarity criterion, these two triangles will become congruent to each other. Okay, so triangle OAP is congruent to triangle OBP. Okay, so when both triangles are congruent, so this half triangle, this one triangle will be half of this OAB. Okay, so when this is equal to each other, then triangle OAP and triangle OBP will be, or angle we can take, it will be half of AOB. Fine. Then what we have to do? We need to find out POA here. So POA we need to find out, POA. So POA or OAP, everything are same. So POA angle is equal to half of AOB angle. Okay, so here AOB angle is, we got AOB as 100 degree, right? So POA angle is equal to half into 100 degree. So 2 1s are 250 is. So the value for POA angle, so therefore POA angle is equal to 50 degree. Is there 50 degree in the option? Yeah, A option. So the first option is the correct one. Hope you understood this. Coming to the fourth question. In fourth question, I have already written the data part. Since it is time consuming, I will explain it to you. So the fourth question is, prove that the tangents drawn at the ends of the diameter of a circle are parallel. Okay, we need to prove that the tangents which are drawn to the circle, tangents are here RS and PQ, the tangents which are drawn to the circle are parallel to each other. Okay, so here data part, the diagram we have to draw during exam. Okay, data part, first we need to write, the data part is, let AB be the diameter of the circle. Okay, here you can see AB. Okay, this AB is the diameter of the circle. Two tangents RS and PQ are drawn to the circle, which intersects at point A and B respectively. Two tangents are drawn. One is RS and the one is PQ. Okay, these two tangents meet the circle at point A and B respectively. Next is O is the center of the circle. So this is the data which I have written. First one is AB is the diameter, O is the center of the circle, RS and PQ are the two tangents which intersects the circle at point A and B respectively. Okay, next, We know that by theorem 4.1, if the radius is drawn to a circle is touching a tangent at a point, then this radius will be perpendicular to the tangent by perpendicular theorem, right? When perpendicular theorem proves, we can write it as OA is perpendicular to RS and OB is perpendicular to PQ. Okay, so this radius OA become perpendicular to RS line and OB become perpendicular to PQ line. So when this become perpendicular, these angles will become 90 degree. Okay, here OAR and OAS both are 90 degree. Okay, here OAR and OAS both are 90 degree. Here in that side OBP and OBQ both are 90 degree. Okay, here OBP and OBQ are 90 degree. Next we can notice here there are two alternate angles, that is OAR is equal to OBQ. This is one alternate angle, and OAS is equal to OBP. This is one alternate angle here. See here, OAR and OBQ. So the alternate angle are those which will be in the shape of Z. Okay, the Z shape angles are alternate angles here. OAR and OBQ are alternate angle, and OAS and OBP are alternate angle. So both are alternate angles. So since both alternate angles are equal, both interior alternate angles are equal, so these lines RS and PQ are parallel to each other. Okay, therefore RS and PQ tangents are parallel to each other. Parallel to each other. Here we need to prove first by perpendicular theorem, this OA is perpendicular to RS and OB is perpendicular to PQ. After that we need to prove that these both angles are 90 degree, then two alternate angles. After that we can write it as, since both interior angles are equal, interior alternate angles are equal, you write here alternate angles, interior alternate angles are equal, RS and PQ tangents are parallel to each other. Hope you understood this. Moving on to the fifth question. The fifth question is theory part, so I have already written that. I will explain you line by line. So the question is, prove that the perpendicular at a point of contact to a tangent to a circle passes through the center. We need to prove that if a perpendicular line is drawn, okay, if a perpendicular line is drawn to the tangent at a point P, then we need to prove that it passes through the center itself. Okay, so for that, first we need to write data. So let us consider a circle with center O. So first you draw a circle with center O, where AB is a tangent which touches the circle at point P. Okay, so draw a circle with center O and draw a tangent which touches a circle at point P. AB is a tangent where P is the point of contact. Okay, this is the initial data. Next, what we have to prove is, we have to prove that the line perpendicular to AB at P passes through the center. We need to prove that if a line is perpendicular to AB at point P passes exactly through the center, we need to prove that. Okay, for this we need to prove it by using contradiction method, that is the reverse method. For that we have to do some assumption. Let us assume that the perpendicular to AB at P does not pass through center O. So contradiction means the reverse form. So now we need to assume that the line is not passing exactly from the center. Let it pass through another point O dash and join OP and O dash P. Okay, next we need to mark another point near to that center point. Okay, near to the center we need to mark another point, let it be O dash, then join OP and O dash P both. Okay, so this is called as contradiction method. Contradiction method means, what I have told you, that we need to prove it is passing through the center O, but we have to take another point near to it, let it be O dash, and we need to join to the P point. Okay, so as perpendicular to AB passes through O, okay, since we have already assumed that this OP, O dash P, is passing through at point P, it is touching the tangent. Okay, if it touches the tangent, then it will be perpendicular line. So this perpendicular line is equal to 90 degree, so O dash P is equal to 90 degree, so this angle is equal to 90 degree. Okay, next, since O is the center of the circle and P is the point of contact, then by theorem 4.1, that is perpendicular theorem, so this we have already proved, O dash P is 90 degree. Now here O is the center of the circle, P is the point of contact, so by theorem 4.1, perpendicular theorem, this will be perpendicular to AB, so OPB is also equal to 90 degree. So let the first one be equation 1 and the second one be equation 2. So now we need to compare equation 1 and equation 2. Okay, by comparing equation 1 and 2, equation 1 is 90 degree, equation 2 is 90 degree. So this both become equal. So O dash P angle is equal to OPB angle. Let it be equation number 3. But this is from the proof. Okay, we have proved this only by the proof section of equation 1 and 2. But from the figure, it can be clearly seen that this O dash P is less than OPB. Okay, so this O dash P is less than OPB. From the figure, we can see the angle. This O dash P angle is less than OPB angle. Right? So, but we here proved it as equal. So, this is possible. So, this equation 3 is possible only if, okay, is possible only if this O dash PB, okay, coincides, means merges, coincides with OPB. Okay, so this is possible, this equation 3 is possible only if, so this OPB line, OP merges with O dash P merges with the OP line. Okay, so if this is possible, then the perpendicular line passes through the center, center which is touching a tangent. Okay, so here, once again I will explain you, here we need to prove that if any line from the center passes, if any line which is perpendicular to this tangent at point P, then it has to pass through the center. So this is the thing we need to prove. For that, we have to draw a circle and a tangent which stretches at point P. So this is the initial data. Later, what we have to do is, we need to consider another point near to that, let it be O dash, and join it. Both OP and O dash P, we need to join it. Next, since we have considered it is perpendicular, so it will become 90 degree, O dash P become 90 degree. Then by perpendicular theorem, OP will also become perpendicular to AB, then it is also 90 degree. Okay, from equation 1 and 2, both are equal, let it be equation 3. But from the figure, we can clearly see that this O dash P is less than OPB. So if we need to prove this equation 3 as correct, then we need to make an assumption, that is, this O dash P merges with OPB. Okay, if that is possible, only at that case the perpendicular at a point of contact to a tangent to a circle passes through the center. Okay, hope you understood this. This is only a theoretical part, there is no proof section for this. The sixth question is, here the length of the tangent from a point A, the length of the tangent is this line, okay, the length of the tangent from a point A at a distance 5 cm from the center. You have to read the question carefully and then you have to write the diagram of it. Okay, the length of a tangent, here the length of a tangent is not given. Okay, the length of a tangent from a point A at a distance 5 cm from the center is 4 cm. So this is 4 cm will be the length of the tangent. We need to find the radius of the circle. So the radius of the circle is OB. We need to find out. Okay. So in the question, they have given tangent AB. So tangent AB is equal to 4 cm. Next, hypotenuse, that is OA. OA is equal to 5 cm. We need to find out OB radius. Okay, OB radius we need to find out. Here this will be 90 degree by theorem 4.1 perpendicular. So here it has become a right angle triangle. Okay, right angle triangle means we can apply Pythagoras theorem. So by Pythagoras theorem, so in right angle, the hypotenuse square, hypotenuse is OA. So hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares on other two sides, that is OB square plus AB square. Okay, OA square, hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares on other two sides. So OA is 5 cm. So 5 square is equal to OB, we need to find out. So write as it is. Next, AB is 4 cm. So 5 square is 25, is equal to OB square plus 4 square is 16. Next, shift 16 to left hand side, it will become 25 minus 16 is equal to OB square. So 25 minus 16 is 9, is equal to OB square. When I shift square to this side, it will become square root. So OB is equal to square root of 9. So square root of 9 is 3 cm. Okay, so radius of a circle, therefore radius of a circle is equal to 3 cm. Is equal to 3 cm. Hope you understood this problem. So this is the last question of this session, that is the 7th question. The 7th question states that two concentric circles are there of radii 5 cm and 3 cm. So the radii of the larger circle is 5 cm. This is the larger circle. The larger circle is 5 cm and the smaller circle is 3 cm radii. Okay. We need to find the length of the chord. So we need to find the length of the chord, that is AB, we need to find out. Okay. So this is the chord, and also this is the chord for the first circle, bigger circle, and it is the tangent for the smaller circle. Okay. We need to find the chord. So here the given data is, first is OA. OA is the radius of bigger circle. So OA is equal to 5 cm and OP is the radius of smaller circle. Okay. OP is the radius of smaller circle. We need to draw this circle. They will give you only this question. So you need to draw two concentric circles where you need to write the radius of two circles and write it in the form of this. Okay. So OP is equal to 3 cm. Here we need to find the chord AB. Okay. AB we need to find out. Just by seeing this diagram, we can see here, since OP is perpendicular to AP, this will be 90 degree. Okay. If this is 90 degree, this AOP will become a right angle triangle. So write the triangle. So this OAP will be a right angle triangle. Okay. OAP. So this will be a right angle triangle where this is 3 and 5. AP we need to find out. So 90 degree is at the P angle. So this OA will be the hypotenuse. So by Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square. So hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares on other two sides, that is AP square plus OP square. Here OA square is equal to 5. So 5 square is equal to AP, we need to find out. So write as it is. And OP square is 3 square. So 5 square is 25, is equal to AP square plus 3 square is 9. Shift 9 to left hand side, will become 25 minus 9 is equal to AP square. 25 minus 9 is 16, is equal to AP square. When I shift square to this side, it will become square root. So root 16 is equal to AP. The value for root 16 is 4. So AP is 4 cm. Okay. So this AP will be 4 cm. Since OP is perpendicular to AB. Okay. Since OP is perpendicular to AB. So this P is midpoint of chord AB. So it is exactly at the midpoint. Okay, so if this is the midpoint, this AP and PB will be equal to each other. So AP will be equal to PB. Okay, so therefore they have asked to find out the value for AB. AB is equal to AP plus PB. Okay, so AP, what is AP? We have already found out, that is 4. So since AP is equal to PB, PB is also equal to 4 itself. Therefore chord AB is equal to 8 cm. Okay, so this is the value for chord. So this is the last question. So still there is 6 questions remaining. There are total of 13 questions where I have solved 7 questions in this session. In the next video, I will be solving next remaining 6 questions. Hope you understood this. So this circles chapter is very important. They will give you the tangent theorem, usually tangent or perpendicular theorem, for 3 marks. And this section, in this exercise 4.2, there will be 2 questions, one in 2 marks, another one in 3 marks. And in exercise 4.1, maybe it will appear for MCQ, multiple choice, or not. So this circles chapter is a super important chapter. So please concentrate and watch till the end. Thank you.